Excuse me. This happened again. There is a book release from Kerala Theosophical Federation, and it is a book of a collection of writings and lectures of Surendra Narayan, who was vice president of the Theosophical Society a long time. And the book is called Live Your Life and Come Into Ours. It is a really new release for this convention. So this is for your announcement and thank you. Now we can all raise.
सहस्रशीर्षापुरुषः सहस्राक्षः सहस्रपात् स भूमिं विश्वतो वृत्वा अत्यतिष्ठत् दशाङ्गुलम् पुरुष एवेदं सर्वं यद्भूतं यच्छभव्यम् उतामृतत्वस्येषानः यदन्नेनातिरोहति एतावानस्य महिमा अथोऽध्यायांश्च पुरुषः पादोऽस्य विश्वा भूतानि त्रिपादस्यामृतं दिवि एको देवः सर्वभूतेषु गूढः सर्वव्यापी सर्वभूतान्तरात्मा कर्माध्यक्षः सर्वभूतादिवासः साक्षी चेता केवलो निर्गुणश्च एको वशी निष्क्रियाणां बहूनां एक Ekam bijam bahudayak karoti tamatmastham paryenu pashyanti dhiraha tesham sukham shashvatam netaresham tacham yoravrani mahe gatum yajnaya gatum yajnapataye Daivi swastirastunah swastirmanushebhyah udvam jigatu bheshajam shanno astu dvipade sham chatushpade om shanti shanti shanti
Yanim mano, yanim vacho, yanim shotnem, asho no jarthustre. Framesha spenta gathao geurvain, nemove gathao asho nish, ayya yasa nimangaha, ustana jasto rafedraya, mainyaus mazda paurvim, spentya asha vispenga shotna. Vangeus kartum manangaho ya khasnevisha geuscha urvanem ya shotnam haitim yasmaide aunavaitim gatham ashonim asheratum yasmaide aunavaintiyao gathayao hanadata yasmaide yenge hatam aat yesne paiti vangaho mazdao ahuro vaetha Ashathacha, yaunga hamcha, tascha, taoscha, yasmaide. Nimascha yar meti sijaycha, nimascha yar meti sijaycha, nimascha yar meti sijaycha, ashone ashem vohu, vaistem asti, usta asti, usta ammai, yadashai, vaista ashem.
Namo Arihantanam, Namo Siddhanam, Namo Ayariyanam, Namo Uvajjayanam, Namo Loe Savvasahunam, Namo Arihantanam, Namo Siddhanam, Namo Ayariyanam, Namo Uvajjayanam, Namo Loe Savvasahunam. Aiso panch namokkaro, Savva pavapanasano, Mangalananch savvesim padamam bhav. Mangalam. Translation. Reverence to the arhats, reverence to the perfect ones, reverence to the heads of the sangha, reverence to the preceptors, reverence to all holy monks in the world. All these five are worthy of reference. They are protectors against sin. Among the all auspicious things, this is the most auspicious.
Namo tasya bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasya. Namo tasya bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasya. Namo tasya bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasya buddham saranam gacchami dhammam saranam gacchami sangam saranam gacchami duryampi buddham saranam gacchami tutiyampi dhammam saranam gacchami tutiyampi sangam saranam gacchami tatiyampi buddham saranam gacchami tatiyampi dhammam saranam gacchami tatiyampi sangam saranam gacchami panati pat veeramani sikha padam samadhiyami adinaradan veeramani Sikkhapadam samadhiyami kameshu michachara veramani sikkhapadam samadhiyami musavada veramani sikkhapadam samadhiyami surameraya majja pama dattana veramani sikkhapadam samadhiyami Translation Praise be to the Lord The Holy One, perfect in wisdom. Praise be to the Lord, the Holy One, perfect in wisdom. Praise be to the Lord, the Holy One, perfect in wisdom. I go to the Buddha for refuge. I go to the law for refuge. I go to the brotherhood for refuge. For the second time, I go to the Buddha for refuge. For the second time, I go to the law for refuge. For the second time, I go to the brotherhood for refuge. For the third time, I go to the Buddha for refuge. For the third time, I go to the law for refuge. For the third time, I go to the brotherhood for refuge. I promise to abstain from taking the life of any living creature. I promise to abstain from taking anything with thievish intent. I promise to abstain from the evil indulgence of bodily passions. I promise to abstain from falsehood. I promise to abstain from any intoxicating liquor or drug. Thank you.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord Christ, we thy faithful soldiers dedicate this newborn day to thee, praying that it may shine in thy service, as a pure pearl in the chaplet of our life. O thou great King of love, to whom be praise and adoration forevermore. Amen. Teach us, O Lord, to see thy life in all men and in all the peoples of thine earth, and so guide the nations into the understanding of thy laws, that peace and goodwill may reign upon earth. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. To the most holy and adorable Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, three persons in one God, to Christ our Lord, the only wise counselor, the Prince of Peace, to the seven mighty spirits before the throne, and to the glorious assembly of just men made perfect, the watchers, the saints, the holy ones, be praise and ceasing from every living creature, and honor, might, and glory henceforth and forevermore. Amen. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.
Bismillah ir-Rahman ir-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawmiddin Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in Ihdina Sirat Al-Mustaqim Sirat Al-Lazina Namta Alayhim Ghayr Al-Maqdubi Alayhim Walad Dalin Ameen.
ओमिकंकार सतनाम करता पुरुख निर्भो निर्वैर अकाल मूरत अजूनी से भंग गुरु प्रसाद जप आदि सच जुगादि सच है भी सच नानक होसी भी सच
O hidden life vibrant in every atom. O hidden light shining in every creature. O hidden love embracing all in oneness. May each who feels himself as one with thee know he is therefore one with every other. I'd like to take this opportunity before we hear the greetings from the various sections around the world to welcome you all to this 142nd convention of the Theosophical Society. A great deal of work has been done in preparing for you all to come here. Many of us you will see on the stage, but the real work that has made it possible for us to be here in comfort and to be able to focus as we will on the various speakers today has been done behind the scenes by a host of people who are working here around you all the time. So as you see them, I'd like for you to give them your appreciation, because really, as deep as and profound as the ideas we are going to share may be, without their work and constant attention, this would not be possible. So, once again, I welcome you, and now we'll hear the greetings from the sections around the world. And we begin from the oldest section down to the newest.
It is with great joy and happiness that I bring greetings to all of you from your brothers and sisters in the United States.
I bring greetings to you all from all the members in England. I wish this convention every success and the delegates an interesting and inspiring time.
On behalf of the Indian section, I would like to convey all the delegates of the 142nd Annual Convention of the Theosophical Society, hearty good wishes and greetings. May we deliberate and have a great convention.
Respected President and friends near and far, it is my great pleasure to bring warmest greetings on behalf of the Australian section to all who are present and best wishes for a fruitful, inspiring and happy time together. May the blessings of the Holy Ones be with us throughout this gathering.
Good morning. I bring the warmest greetings and wishes for a lucky convention from all members in Sweden.
I bring greetings from New Zealand, from all the branches, their members, and wish you a joyful and inspiring convention. Thank you.
Dear friends from all over the world, I'm happy to bring greetings to you all from the Theosophical Society in the Netherlands and the International Theosophical Centre at Naarden. We wish you a very pleasant and inspiring convention.
I'm very glad to bring and share with you all the greetings from all theosophists from France. May the healing energy coming out from altruistic heart help us getting to a better and more united world.
Respected President, brothers and sisters here and far, on behalf of the Italian section and of its General Secretary, Antonio Girardi, I wish you a successful and inspiring convention. May the beauty and peace of this sacred place bless and inspire all of us.
Good morning, dear friends. On behalf of the Finnish section, I bring you warm greetings and best wishes for a fruitful and inspiring convention.
Dear friends, on behalf of the Belgian section, most kind and fraternal greetings to you all and best wishes for a unifying 142nd International Convention.
Dear friends, I'm very happy and honored of being here, having the opportunity of delivering the greetings of all members of the Argentinian section. I wish you to all us a very inspiring convention.
With great joy, on behalf of Brazilian section, we bring you warmest wishes and we may the Mighty One blessings be with you all. Thank you.
Respected President, friends here and all over the world, I, on behalf of the members of the Spanish section, I am bringing to you the warmest greetings and the best wishes for this convention to be most inspiring and enriching. Thank you.
Good morning, dear brothers and sisters.
From the officers and members of the Theosophical Society in the Philippines, we bring you our greetings and hope that our convention will be a fulfilling and successful one.
Good morning. I'm standing here on behalf of West African Section, conveying a goodwill message to all members and wishing that this 142nd convention will be a great success and send goodwill to all corners of the world.
From the cold north, I bring warm greetings to all the friends gathered here in Adyar. And on behalf of the Norwegian Regional Association and all its 19 members, I bring you the warmest greetings and wish you, all delegates, great success in the exploration of this very important theme, from teachings to insight and how to awaken the altruistic heart. So, good luck to us all. Thank you.
Respected President, brothers and sister, it is an honor and a privilege to be here and to bring you the warmest greeting and the best wishes from all the members of Canada. Thank you.
Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. I bring you the warmest greeting from the section from Uruguay.
Amigos, les traigo un caluroso saludo de Centroamérica. Friends, I bring the hearty greetings from Central America, wishing you, all of us, a very fruitful convention.
Dear brothers and sisters, I'm very honored to be here with you in this sacred place. I'm bringing you warm fraternal greetings from the Theosophical Society in Slovenia, and best wishes for fruitful and inspiring convention for the benefit of the humanity and all life. Thank you.
Respected Mr. President, dear brothers and sisters, I send you the best wishes for the benefit of this convention and also for coming a new year, from the CS members of Ukraine.
Dear President, dear Representative, dear sister and brother, I bring you the warmest greeting from Switzerland. I hope that this convention will be very pleasant. Thank you very much.
Hearty greetings to you all, brothers and sisters, from 300 members from Bangladesh. You will be happy that this small country is becoming very active in the Theosophical Society. We won this convention a grand success. Thank you.
Honored President, respected General Council members, beloved brothers and sisters, both here and around the world. I bring greetings from the Theosophical Order of Service International and best wishes as we explore and develop altruism during this 142nd convention.
Last but I hope not least, good morning. Aria Theater, good morning, friends, and good morning, seekers for truth. On behalf of International Theosophy Conference, that is a platform where theosophists from all the various theosophical mainstreams meet, its president, Dr. Eugene Jennings, and the two vice presidents, Herman C. Vermeulen, and myself, Jan-Nicolas Kind, I'm here to wish you all the participants and delegates a tremendously inspiring 142nd International Convention. May this gathering bring us closer. May it open up many an altruistic heart. And above all, let it be a true celebration of theosophy.
There has also been received many letters for greetings to the convention and emails and Facebook messages and such. They come from all continents of the world. I will not repeat them, but everyone wishes a very successful convention and keeping in mind the altruistic heart and getting into the insight of theosophy. Here we just heard 16 representatives of sections and six representatives for theosophical associations and three representatives from over theosophical agencies. This is the structure which the Theosophical Society Adyar has, depending on how many lodges the countries have and how many members and activity. We wish all that the activities will increase in each part of the world and with all our in all our hearts especially. Now we next we have the presidential address.
Would you please rise so that we may invoke the blessings of those elder brethren who stand behind this society and its movement? May those who are the embodiments of love immortal bless this society with their help and guidance. Bless this society which was founded for their work. May they inspire it with their wisdom, strengthen it with their power, and energize it with their activity. Thank you. You may be seated. Just a few words before we come to our formal address, which again this year will be presented in the form of a video. This is the year 2017, of course, marks the 142nd year that such international gatherings have been held. Longevity, as we all know, is a good thing. Probably what happens in, whether it's a person or an organization that lives a long time, the question is always, what is the secret? My mother is 99 years old, and hardly a place I go does she not get the question, what is the secret for your longevity? Probably it's something that is good, but more importantly than longevity is the value of what has been done within those years. It's a wonderful thing to be around for a long time, but something is necessary to justify that existence. There are people, there are organizations who come into the world for a moment, who do their work, and then who leave the scene the only mark which they leave behind being the mark which they leave on the hearts and in the souls of those whom they touched. There are other organizations, people who are around a long time, who have somehow managed to limp their way into the future, forgetful of the reason for their being, cut off from that vitalizing principle which gives meaning to their work. It is not enough from the perspective of the Theosophical Society and the movement that came about with its founding. Just to endure is not sufficient. When the Theosophical Society was founded, we have our three objects. These are objects which have given direction to this movement over the course of its lifespan. But the reason for it coming into existence has been expressed very differently than the language of those objects. In the Key to Theosophy, H.P. Blavatsky makes the simple statement that the reason for the Theosophical Society is to assist in showing that such a thing as theosophy exists. That's one thing that she says. The next thing that she says is that it is also here to help people in studying and assimilating its eternal truths. In the early days of the Theosophical Society, there was no language. There was no common language to talk about these matters of the inner life. The development of such a language that could spread throughout the world was the early work of the Theosophical movement. That has been done rather well. Anywhere in the world we go, there are people who can intelligently engage in a consideration of matters of a deeper nature. So now a different turn of this work seems to fall to us. Having shown that such a thing as theosophy exists, the matter now comes down to the assimilation of these eternal truths. That's the thing that stands before us. To move from teachings to insight, to make the movement from students to those who can exemplify those teachings in our lives and in our behaviors. The great Albert Schweitzer was once asked if he felt that example was the best way to teach. His comment, I think, serves us well. In response, he said, example is not the main thing in influencing others. It is the only thing. We have been blessed with a wisdom. We have been blessed with an avenue through which it is possible to connect more deeply with that wisdom. And we have been blessed with being born in a time when the outflowing of that wisdom has never been more needed. So during our time together at this convention, the necessary harmony of the heart, the altruistic heart, that can come from such a gathering of many minds, many souls, pointed toward what it is that we can do in this world. We look forward to a great benefit and a great blessing to those of us who are here, but more importantly, to this world to which this Theosophical movement is dedicated. So at this point, those of you who have been coming to these conventions for many years know that in the past we used to read the work that has been done in the sections around the world. There's a lot of things going on in all the many places where the Theosophical Society exists. And that was a fairly long process. I do know that when I used to sit out here in the audience previously and I had to listen, it was probably the most painful moment of the opening. Then I found myself up here in front of the microphone and it became more painful. So what we're going to do at this point is we're going to do it in the form of a movie, and I do hope that it's something that can be instructive and also enjoyable to you. So we're going to take a moment to set that up, and then we'll, for the next 47 minutes and 16 seconds, I'd like your devoted attention, please.
highlight of the year's activities was the 38th European Congress, held in Barcelona, Spain, from the 21st to the 26th of August. The theme was Theosophy, a Way Toward Universal Consciousness. The Congress was organized by the European Federation and the Spanish section of the TS, and more than 200 members from 18 countries attended. I gave the opening lecture on the theme, and other lectures were given by several general secretaries, officers of the TS, and president of the Point Loma Society in The Hague, Herman Vermeulen. A session of question and answers preceded the closing. The whole program is available on both the websites of the Federation and of the Spanish section. On June 25th, the General Secretary, Ms. Angels Torra, gave a lecture during the French Convention on What is Spirituality? During the year, several silent meditation retreats were organized, which were well attended and highly motivating. The Austrian Regional Association reports the joining of three new members during the year for a total membership of 58. All three lodges offer weekly lectures throughout the study year, and study subjects are based on classical theosophical teachings and related subjects. Offered lectures are regularly placed on the TS Austria website, and their members receive the Adyar periodical magazine from the German section, which is published 3 times per year. The TS in Belgium has 78 members spread over 8 active lodges. The section's activities continued throughout the country, mostly centered in the north and the capital of Brussels. During the year, they welcomed Mrs. Tranti Kim Du in Brussels for a well-attended and appreciated 2-day seminar on the Indian epic, the Mahabharata. Another highlight was their New Year's reception, featuring a video of Mr. Vikhau Chin's lecture during the International Convention on the Religions of the Future. During the same event, the long-expected website of the Belgian Theosophical Society, www.ts-belgium.be, was launched, along with the launch of a new general brochure to help them increase its presence in Belgium. The national president of the TS England, Jenny Baker, reports that David Neuigers led an introductory course on the ancient theosophy of Plotinus, titled The Return of the Soul to the One. It was one of the year's highlights. Also, in September of 2017, the History and Archives group of their section organized a successful international conference exploring the life and works of Annie Besant, with guest speakers from many countries, including the USA, France, Italy, the Netherlands, and England. Leslie Price, Janet Lee, and others continue to catalog and conserve the section's extensive archives. Ms. Baker spoke at several lodges throughout the year and attended the 38th European Congress in Barcelona. At the closing ceremony, she was presented with the European Federation banner because in the year 2020, the English section will be the host of the 39th European Congress.
The annual convention of the Finnish section was held in Tampere on 8th of April. The summer school in June was at Kravela with Vincent Hao Chin Jr. as our guest speaker, whose self-transformation seminar, ST, was a real success. 9 persons expressed their wish to become ST facilitators. For the first time, they used simultaneous translation equipment, and it was much appreciated. A new study group, called the Self-Transformation Study Group, began in October 2016 in Helsinki. It based its studies on Vikhau Chin Jr.'s book, The Process of Self-Transformation. A revised Finnish translation of SD was published in June jointly by Kalevala and the Minerva Lodges. In Estonia, the lodges arranged summer school in June with the theme, Possibilities of Human Life. They also had a winter seminar in Tallinn in January. H.P. Blavatsky's The Secret Doctrine SD study dates in Tartu in May, and an autumn study camp in August. A revised Finnish translation of SD was published in June jointly by Klevala and Minerva Lodges. The section has 379 members. Courses were offered free of charge every fortnight. Video projections of Jay Krishnamurti's talks took place quarterly. Public lectures were given quarterly with a minimal or no charge. The work of lodges continued steadily, with meetings taking place once a month and stress given to basic theosophical subjects. There was a revival of the lodges in the Congo, and the French section sent them several introductions.
Mr. Janos Zabari and Executive Committee were elected. They have 33 members in three lodges, one in the countryside and two in
to the same goal. The head of each of the eight active lodges is responsible for providing lectures. The titles included A Date with the Universe, Self-Image, Life and Happiness, The Future of the World, The Voice of the Silence, Krishnamurti and Magic. At their annual general meeting last May, Haldor Haraldsson withdrew as GS and Christine August Fridtjofsson was elected as the next General Secretary. Their membership has risen to 283 from 262. On 27th of May, the All-Ireland Convention was held in the centrally located city of Dublin, which was very well supported by members from the Belfast and Phoenix Lodges. They had Gerard Brennan as their guest speaker, a visiting Australian member who is also affiliated to TS Ireland. The theme was The Journey of the Wild Swans, and his talk was profound, inspiring, and very well received and appreciated by those present. The organizing secretary had frequent contact with all Irish members during the year through her circulars with TS News and quarterly study notes. The long-standing members are studying a course on the voice of the silence. The Theosophical books and magazines
1,000 subscriptions. The section has 925 members, a slight decrease from last year. The Netherlands reports a membership of 323 in 9 lodges and 6 study centers. There were 7 national activities in the International Theosophical Center, ITC, in Naarden during the year, including 2 in English, 1 with Fernando de Torrijos from the U.S., from the 23rd to the 28th of June on mindfulness, and on September 3rd, Tim Boyd held a lecture in the morning for members and another in the afternoon for the general public. Their quarterly magazine, Theosophia, is also published online. Many different activities were presented in the lodges and centers, lectures, meditation, and study. Films of Jay Krishnamurti are also shown on a regular basis. And then gave a public lecture there and also in Porto. Although it was a short visit, it was apparently a pleasure for all involved. The section keeps busy every fortnight with a public session in different formats, all of them well attended. 4 members, including the General Secretary, Ana Maria Sosa, attended the European Congress. They continue publishing regularly their magazine Osiris, either in paper or online. The lodges in Lisbon, Porto, and Évora, and also the study group in Azores and Setúbal, go work.
The TS in Russia reports that this year a Theosophical publishing house was created. Russian-Ukrainian relations were strengthened, and construction of the Siberian Theosophical Center in the Altai continued. Their website is administered by the former and current presidential representatives, Pavel Malakov and Alexei Bisputin. Other related activities in the internet include a forum of the TS in Russia, Teopedia, a webinar for studying the secret doctrine, Moscow TS, Siberian Theosophical Center, News of Theosophy, and Vestnik Theosophy, a magazine. They report a membership of 133, a drop of 37 from last year, and very active 8 lodges and 1 study center. The regional association in Slovenia has 55 members and 4 lodges. Their quarterly newsletter, Theosophical Thought, was published regularly, and all memorial days of the TS were celebrated. The Swedish section has 151 members in 6 lodges and 1 study center, and their magazine is issued 4 times per year. They have arranged mini schools at the headquarters in Stockholm twice a year with about 20 participants each. Their summer school featured Big Hao Chin Jr. from the Philippines, who was a very good teacher on the theme Transform Yourself, Transform Your Life, Modern Insight. Finnish section members working at Krela were very good organizers. As of 17th of June, the TS in Switzerland had a new presidential representative, Mr. Andrea Biasca Caroni, in the place of Mrs. Eliane Gaillard, who did valuable work for 12 years. The agency has 27 members, an increase of 4 from last year, in 2 lodges and 2 city centers. One lodge had meetings in Ascona, and the other courses on Theosophy in Geneva. The Lugano study group met fortnightly. In September, Svetlana Gerilenko was re-elected as organizing secretary of the TS in Ukraine for another three-year term. The 100 members in six lodges and three study centers met regularly to study classic Theosophical literature. Their annual convention was held in Kiev in November on the theme Compassion and Universal Responsibility, with more than 40 participants from eight cities, including Moscow. Their summer school was held in Odessa in July on Creativity as a Spiritual Path, with more than 30 participants from six cities.
The Welsh Regional Association was founded in 1922. Membership now stands at 68 in four lodges and one study center. The lodges have been holding monthly study meetings for their members. They have been discussing the basic wisdom teachings as presented in Tim Wyatt's Cycles of Eternity. Every member in Wales received a free copy of the book paid for by the Regional Association. The General Secretary of the East and Central African Section, Narendra M. Shaw, reports that the highlight of this year was the visit of Vic Houchin Jr. from the Philippines, who was the guest speaker at their section's 48th convention held at Kampala, Uganda, from the 12th to the 14th of April, on the art and science of happiness. He delivered three public lectures during the three-day convention. He also toured all the regions in East and Central Africa during his 19-day trip, giving six public talks in different cities. In Nairobi, he conducted a very successful self-transformation seminar. The section was sad to see him go. Their membership is now at 136 in five lodges. The South African section has gone through difficult times over recent months. It has six lodges, but membership has been affected by the large number of emigrations to the US, Canada, Australia, and Europe. It has 135 members, a drop of 16 from last year. The crime wave in South Africa is another factor affecting attendance at lodge meetings. The Deputy General Secretary, Desmond Douglas Chapman, visited Durban twice, Cape Town, and Germiston. He has spoken to lodge presidents about implementing a diploma course, and because many tutorials are involved, he will train the presidents and one other member from each lodge on how to present the course for local classes. The assignments will be sent to their head office for evaluation.
The West African Section Annual Convention was held on 8th and 9th of July with three lectures on technology, theology, and science. After each lecture, there were questions and contributions which enriched their deliberations. Topics taken up at the council meeting held during the convention were 1. Establishment of a bookshop, 2. A TS West Africa journal, 3. Study programs, and 4. Publicity activities and public lectures. Their membership is steady at 242 in 11 lodges. The presidential representative of the TS in East and Southeast Asia, Mr. Chang Sani, informs us that the TS is present in four countries: Singapore, Malaysia, Japan, and Myanmar, with an active lodge in each. The Singapore Lodge, formed in 1889, is the largest, with a membership of 358. The team that develops the Chinese website is based in this lodge. The Selangor Lodge, formed in 1929, is the sole lodge in Malaysia and has 94 members. Japan's 45 Cathedral Nippon Lodge in Tokyo has 45 members. The Yangon Theosophical Society in Myanmar has the Alcott Lodge with 46 members. The total number of members for the presidential agency is 543, a decrease of 8 from last year.
The Australian section membership is reported at 812 in 11 lodges and 6 study centers. Notable highlights of their activities during the year included the January National Convention in Hobart on the theme Eastern Spirituality, Psyche and the Human Journey, featuring a fine public talk by Dr. Bruno Kayun on the core mechanisms of Buddhist spirituality. An audio file of his talk has been uploaded onto the national website. The very successful tour by Dr. Pablo Sender from the USA, which included the School of Theosophy, as well as his weekend seminar at Launceston, which was professionally recorded. He spoke at several lodges. There is an offer of an annual prize at the University of Western Australia for a third-year undergraduate course on philosophy, East and West. An official response is awaited. Interestingly, their book depot of some 50 specially selected books at the national headquarters continued to attract sales during the year at cost recovery prices. The presidential representative of Bangladesh, Mr. B.L. Bhattacharya, reports that 2 new lodges were chartered and 3 more are in process, which will be inaugurated by him when he visits them next. He kept close contact with all the lodges and sent them study materials, including At the Feet of the Master and I.K. Timney's Principles of Theosophical Work. Their membership is now 300, an increase of 27 from last year. The annual convention of the Indian section, with 11,394 members in 408 lodges under 16 federations, was inaugurated by me and chaired by International Vice President Dr. Chittarajan Satapathy at Adyar in January. The section had a change of guard, with Mr. Pradeep H. Gohil assuming the post of General Secretary, succeeding Mr. S. Sundaram, and Mr. Pradeep Mahapatra being nominated as the Joint General Secretary. The short talks by Mr. O.P. Aneha, Ms. Nandita Kuldeep, and Dr. P.S.P. Sarangi on self-preparation is an important aspect of theosophical work were well received by the delegates. The 15th East Zone TS and TOS Conference, including the Bangladesh section, was held over 2 days in February on Theosophy in Theory and Practice, with Mr. B.L. Bhattacharya, the TOS National Director, as chief guest. Theosophy, Defining the Undefinable, was the theme for the 3-day 94th South India Conference at Adyar in April, inaugurated by Maria Artama, International Secretary, welcomed by Mr. Gohil, and attended by around 100 delegates. There were talks by 4 speakers, followed by workshops. The section headquarters at Varanasi hosted the North India Study Camp, held over 3 days in October 2016, on N. Sriram's An Approach to Reality, directed by Professor R.C. Tempe. A series of over 5 study camps were conducted from April to June at the Himalayan Center for Theosophical Studies in Mowali, on topics such as Self-Realization Through Love, the book by I.K. Timney, Teachings of J. Krishnamurti, the Upanishads from a Theosophical Perspective, and more. Visits and talks were conducted at various locations during the year by the national lecturers, Professor C.A. Shinde, Mr. S.K. Pandey, Mr. L. Nagesh, Mr. Shikhar Agnihotra, Ms. Varsha B. Patel, Dr. R.V. Vastrad, Mr. B.D. Tendulkar and Ms. Avantika Mehta. The Central Property Committee, set up last year at Varanasi to manage the properties of the society, started work on reconstruction of facilities, obtaining legal title for properties, and so on. The South Zone Conference was held over 2 days in July at Kakinada with Nancy Secris, the International Secretary of the TOS and Treasurer for the Theosophical Society, as chief guest. North Zone Conference was held in Varanasi in August, with the General Secretary officiating as chief guest. The Indian Theosophist, the magazine of the Indian section, had a special issue commemorating the 100th anniversary of Annie Besant's elevation to the presidentship of the Indian National Congress, the organization that eventually secured independence for India. The Indonesian section reports an increase of 15 members and one more lodge, totaling 209 members in 15 lodges and one study center. The president of the Covenant Lodge, Abraham Aron, in Tel Aviv, Israel, had weekly study sessions for members on a variety of subjects. They also held 3 seminars during the year, ranging from 28 to 34 participants. The last one in June was led by Tran T. Kim Du, chairman of the European Federation, which was well received. Their YouTube channel now has more than 40 films, some of them full-length lectures on various theosophical topics. They have 67 members and 7
The New Zealand section hosted the Indo-Pacific Federation Conference in Auckland from 14th to 19th of October 2016, with 110 delegates attending from around the Indo-Pacific region, with several guests from Europe and Brazil. They were pleased to have Tim and Lily Boyd in attendance. Their science seminar followed from 19th to 21st of October with speakers with professional scientific backgrounds from Australia, France, India, and New Zealand. Their annual convention was held in Dunedin in January 2017, with guest speakers Tran T. Kim Du from France and Elena Doval Santos from the USA, with the theme Theosophy, Science, Spirituality, and Consciousness. A School of Theosophy was held in May with Director of Studies, International Speaker Dorothy Bell, exploring the theme of Theosophical Worldview, The Power Revealed. The section sent 7 national speakers to the 13 branches around the country to support their work. Their membership stands at 619, including 4 study centers. The TS in the Philippines convention was held at their national headquarters with Vice President of the Philippine Republic, Lenny Robredo, as the guest speaker. During the convention, a new set of National Board of Trustees was elected, including the re-election of Roselmo Doval Santos as National President. The General Council of the TS unanimously approved Mr. Vic Hao Chins Jr.'s election as additional member of the General Council upon President Tim Boyd's nomination. The section headquarters continues to publish the Theosophical Digest, the Philippine Theosophist, the TOS newsletter, and Peace Ideas. They sponsored a 3-hour Zen meditation session conducted by Sister Sonia Punzalan, a Catholic nun, with the support of Father Efron Borromeo and others. She led the practice of Zazen and body movements and shared with the audience the basic quality of consciousness being nurtured in Zen, seeing things as held in Buenos Aires during the week before Easter on reincarnation and life after death. It was attended by over 70 members and visitors from Argentina and Uruguay. Both their summer schools took place in the San Rafael Theosophical Center. Mr. Langlois attended the last international convention in Adyar, the strategic planning meeting in Arden, and also visited seven lodges across the country. In February, a new website was opened for the section, and also a YouTube channel which includes, among other materials, Tim Boyd's video blog with subtitles in Spanish.
The Bolivian General Secretary, Mrs. Guillermina Rios de Sandoval, participated in the Inter-American Federation Congress that took place in Brasilia on the Master's Letters, and the section sent José Luis Rojas to participate in the International Gathering of Young Theosophists in February in the same city. Their national meeting was held in La Paz with the theme, the TS, why and for what purpose it was founded. Their 124 members are spread over 11 lodges and 6 study centers. The Brazilian section continues to be the largest in Latin America, with 676 members in 33 lodges and 20 study centers. They have a new general secretary, Sergio Carvalho de Moraes Jr., succeeding Marcos de Resende. Their general council got together twice during the year, in January during their summer school and again in July during their winter school, held at the Theosophical Institute in Brasilia. Their International Theosophical School, held in the same venue in Brasilia, had Esteban Langlois, General Secretary of the Argentinian Section, as its visiting lecturer, who spoke on Applied Theosophy, Abstract Teachings for a Concrete Life. The International Youth Group met in February on Diversity as a Way to Universal Brotherhood. Sophia Magazine has entered its 15th year with 636 subscribers. It sells at newsstands all over the country. The Canadian Regional Association, CRA, reports a membership of 124, an increase of 6 from last year, working in 5 lodges and 2 study groups. All lodges have been active, holding at least monthly meetings. In late August, York Lodge hosted the CRA's annual convention with Michael Gomes from New York City as the speaker for a conference on HPB, Her Life and Work. On the 26th and 27th of August, Les Montagnes Bleues Lodge had its 3rd summer school with guest speaker Jacques Manique from France, who spoke on Science and Theosophy. The TS in Chile, the membership stands at 47, working in 3 lodges. Their convention was held in March with the theme Live Spiritually. Pamphlets are distributed on subways and on electronic pages. Both the Chilean Theosophical Magazine, a hard copy printed version, and the electronic Theosophical brochure are sent monthly to different Spanish-speaking countries. They have an online radio program, which transmits lectures and classes, a blog, a Facebook page, and a Twitter account. These last 3 online publications have been very well received.
The Colombian Presidential Agency has a membership of 28 working in 4 lodges and 4 study centers that keep active studying a variety of theosophical teachings and authors. In the TS in Costa Rica, there are 52 members in 5 lodges. Although the lodges meet at least weekly and one meets twice per week, The attendance is low overall, and most of them did not submit their reports to the presidential representative. The Cuban Section Annual Convention was celebrated on 14th and 15th of January with the theme Seven Levels of Divine Love. Doctors Isaac Howley and Enrique Reig from Mexico presented a series of programs at the national headquarters in Havana from 15th to 22nd of March, which was very much appreciated. They gave a public conference about the inner child and two meetings for members, how to live theosophy in the modern world, and the philosophy of impermanence. The section's two-day summer school was organized as a workshop for members by the lodges in Havana on letters from the Masters of the Wisdom, first series compiled by C. Ginarajadasa. Their magazine, Revista Theosófica Cubana, continues as an electronic quarterly. The section, which has 572 members in 12 lodges, is the second largest in Latin America. The TS in the Dominican Republic reports that they have 34 members in 2 lodges and 1 study center. The major events of Atma Lodge in Santo Domingo were several lectures given in late March by Drs. Isaac Howley and Enrique Reig on keys to overcome suffering. Also in Santo Domingo, a group of members inaugurated the H.P. Blavatsky study group in August under the guidance of Felipe de Castro. It meets weekly at a new location in Santo Domingo. Theosophical topics are discussed and presented weekly by Nueva Aurora members in Rio Plata for the general public, which has been very successful.
The Mexican section welcomed Drs. Isaac Howley and Enrique Reig last December, who conducted the section's School of the Wisdom program. The section also supported the Inter-American Theosophical Federation program in realizing the lectures given by Professor P. Krishna. In September, the new Guadalajara Study Center was certified. Three members in 2 quite active lodges, holding 16 public talks between them during the year. They also offered a free internet course of theosophy for the public. They also had their usual studies and meetings for members. Their highlight of the year was that they could finally raise enough funds to buy land in December to build their own hall for public lectures. It holds around 50 or more people, and to possibly house their 2 lodges.
Regional Association in Uruguay gained 2 members, now standing at 58 in 5 lodges. They hold weekly meetings and studies are based on classical theosophical literature, J. Krishnamurti, E. Tolle, and Jesus Zetón's Sacred Geometry. They also study articles published in Sofia, the official magazine of the TS in Spain, and from the internet on modern physics, science, and archaeology. videos of seminars in Spain and lectures of Juan Vinas in Brasilia were also shown. A course was also given by the organizing secretary, Emma de Souza Leal, on an approach to theosophy.
The TS in the United States has 3,323 members in 35 lodges and 46 study centers. During the year, Tim Boyd, international president, ended his second 3-year term of service as president of the TSA, and Barbara Hebert, former vice president, assumed the presidency. David Bruce remains the national secretary, and Floyd Kettering continues as the national treasurer. Mr. Bruce reports that 2 new study centers were certified during the year. He organized 42 lectures or workshops at lodges, study centers, camps, and federations. The Henry Steele Alcott Memorial Library and Archives is central to a growing theosophical community worldwide. Their archivist, Janet Kirshner, and Pablo Sender continue to coordinate construction of their Theosophy Wiki encyclopedia online, available now in English, Spanish, Russian, French, and in Italian. The IT department, managed by Chris Bolger, are undertaking a complete redesign of the main TSA website, www.theosophical.org. They are also starting a new project with Quest Books to produce audio versions of some of their more popular paperback titles. These will be sold via download from Amazon.com. The Quest Bookshop in Wheaton has an average of 1,000 sales per month. Over 3,000 customers receive a monthly e-newsletter announcing special sales. The Public Programs Committee, chaired by John Cianciosi, organizes a wide range of programs for study, meditation, service, and community participation. By webcasting their Thursday night lectures, they are reaching a growing national and international audience. Also, they have continued to increase their number of online, interactive webinar programs.
So I hope you enjoyed. Gives you something of the flavor of the work that is being done in all of your countries around the world. And I hope you enjoyed looking at yourselves as well. I saw some of you smile when your faces popped up. But anyway, at this point, I can declare this convention officially open. Convention is open. The session is closed.